What's going on, folks? Ed Johnson here, and welcome to the first episode of Nerd News for 2012, episode 7, officially, I think. And I'm finally back. I finally got an episode in January, which I really tried to get 4 episodes in, but as you know, I am not the best scheduler, if you've been watching anyway. But let me start off the top of the show by giving a big shout out to my homegirl Ms. A for her birthday yesterday. She's only 12 years old. Congratulations to her. I'm only kidding. She's well beyond 12. Not well beyond. She's still young. Anyway, happy birthday to Ms. A. I heard she had a really good time last night going to go see Rakim at the Freedom Party last night. The Freedom Party apparently is always a great event. I never get there because I'm an old pedophile that stays at home and watches cartoons and reads comic books. But my friend, acquaintance, guy I know, Mark Smooth, is the promoter for that party. And apparently, it's always something to go check out. I will put an URL somewhere on the screen for you guys to go check it out, but it's down on Bleecker Street somewhere, I think. I don't know. As I said, I'm an old man that doesn't do anything. But Rakim was there last night, and Lisa was there for her birthday party, and I hope she had a good time. I hadn't gotten to talk to her today, but, you know, she's probably hungover and wasn't going to answer the phone anyway. So shout out to her. Happy birthday, Ms. A, my former podcasting co-host. What else is going on? As you know, I just wanted to confirm again the announcement that Nerd Word, the official podcast, is over. And it's unfortunate. It was a really tough decision for me to make, but I got a lot of, you know, when was the next one, when was the next one, and I didn't know. I got tired of saying I don't know, and it was just scheduling issues. We just couldn't get our stuff together, so better to put it on a long hiatus and have like a special comeback show eventually at some point than to continuously promise that there's going to be another show. So the 16 shows that are up, you can all hear on my site. There's one in the can that we recorded way back in December that hasn't been posted yet. So that one will hopefully be posted at some point. I don't have the file, so I can't promise you exactly when that's going to go up. But at some point it'll go up, and that'll be your special last episode of Nerd Word until we figure out whether or not we're going to do it. Now, I say last episode, but, you know, some things may happen that might change that, and or I may change the format of it and continue to do it. Nonetheless, you'll always get these video casts, and I'll be continuing to do this. So, what else is there? Well, you know, tonight on Fox at 8 o'clock will be the UFC fight. Listed is Michael Brisbane against Chanel Sonnen, and then the main fight will be the Evans-Davis fight. So the Brisbane-Sonnen fight is going to be a lot of fun, I think. They are hyping the hell out of that fight up, and I'm looking forward to seeing what happens with those two guys. Sonnen is an incredible personality, and just a lot of fun to watch and listen to. And the Evans-Davis thing, Evans just seems to be taking it a lot more personally than Davis is. My pick is Davis. I'm going to announce that on this here. And Sonnen is my pick in the Brisbane fight. I like Michael Brisbane, but I just don't believe that he's got what it takes to take a monster like Chanel down. He has that fire in him. So what we're going to do is we're going to have like our top 10 at 10, top 10 in 10. So the next few minutes, I just want to blast out the top 10 stories that were posted on my website this week. And we're going to start off with the fact that the little snippet of a song that Obama gave in his speech, the Al Green, let's stay together, sentence that he sort of harmonized to in his speech, boosted the sales of that track 500%. It was selling like gangbusters, and Al Green is a very happy reverend right now. So I'm going to ask Obama to just say the words nerd word so people might actually see one of these videos. Number two in our top 10 is, again, the UFC fight, as I mentioned, Bisping and Sonnen, and Evans and Davis fighting tonight at 8 o'clock on Fox. You can catch all of the prelim shows on Fuel, and they started at 5 p.m. Eastern. So they're going on right now. So wanted to say that really kicking out these the strips, the nerd word strips, and we're doing slideshows, we're doing onesies every day. It's the header on my Facebook page every day. I try to change it, and there's probably a new one up every day, some silly joke. And we're going to eventually, once I have at least 100 of these, they're going to be released as a book. So hope I'm just going to be taking donations for that book, hopefully. And there's also a donations button on my site, just in case you feel like you have way too much money in your pockets and you just feel, think, hey, I think Ed should have this money because I'm not going to do anything with it. I'll be glad to take that from you. Anyway, so the Nerd Word strips are going to be updated every Wednesday. The strips themselves, we're going to turn, I'm calling it a stripcom. It's a strip sitcom, and I'm going to be updating them every Wednesday. So go to my YouTube channel, which you can find through my website, and you will be able to get that. We're at 6 minutes, so we're going to shoot through the rest of these. My number four is the announcement of the February Toy Fair that I will be at. There will be quite a bit of video from that because I'll be there all 3 days. Got my press pass, yay! From February 12th to the 15th, and we're going to be covering everything that we can on all the new toys that are coming out. So there's that. I posted a video for the new Armored Core multiplayer gameplay, and I'll be listing a link of that on the video somewhere, and you guys should really go check that out. That shit looks amazing. I can't wait to play it. It is what you believe it should be like flying a mech, and it's incredible. Another video that was posted this week was the assassination cutscene from the new game Binary Domain, and that, if the gameplay is anything like that cutscene, which I believe it's very close to, I've seen some of the gameplay and it's amazing. Check out the cutscene. It's extensive, great acting, really great animation. Worth it. Number seven is the Kinect Star Wars new cutscene. Not cutscene, it's a trailer for the Star Wars Kinect game. And it stars Andy from Parks and Rec. I forget the actor's name. But they redo the famous scene between Darth Vader and Obi-Wan Kenobi, and Andy is Obi-Wan Kenobi, and it's very funny. I'll add a link to that as well. It's really worth going to check out. Funny as hell. Number eight is the review of the HTC, the new HTC phone by PhoneDog. Check it out. I'll put a link to it. It's a two-parter. Each part is about 10 to 15 minutes. It's very extensive on how good this new phone is. I didn't even put the code. I didn't even put the name of the flipping thing on here, so I don't know what I'm talking about. There are at least three or four mentions of Mass Effect on in a couple of videos that I posted this week, and one of them has a huge spoiler as to some of the new characters, and the other is it like a 12-minute demo of the game that you should go check out. It's incredible. Last story is that there is an announcement exclusive to the PS3 in Tekken versus Street Fighter. You can play as both Pac-Man and the original Mega Man design off of the Mega Man box from way, way back. So now those are just exclusive to the PS3, and Microsoft didn't offer up any exclusives, so there aren't any for the 360 version, but it's going to be kind of cool to play as Mega Man or Pac-Man in that game. Some honorable mentions. Iron Sky. There's a trailer for this independent film called Iron Sky about Nazis from the dark side of the moon. I think that's what it is. And damn computer. And it looks amazing. I swear to God, these independent filmmakers with the toys that are available to them now, Hollywood should be quaking in their boots because these young guys are really coming out with some amazing things. And lastly, there's another video done by a guy named Dugan Kanduku. I apologize for butchering the shit out of that name, but he made an incredible Batman The Dark Knight Rises opening credit sequence, and it's really worth seeing. Again, all of these things will be linked to the video, and you'll be able to click on them and just go straight to them. But that's my 10 at 10, and that's what we're going to be doing from now on, just announcing some of the top stories that were posted on edjohnsonpresents.com for the week, and things that I think that you should check out that you probably might have missed. I will be back next Saturday with another video, and I'll settle up with this whole podcast situation, because I still want to do it. I just don't know how I'm going to do it. And that's it. Thanks for checking me out again. I really appreciate the time. I really appreciate the follows and support on the fan pages and the groups and all of that. Keep it going. Let me know via feedback as to whether or not I'm doing anything that you don't like or like, and I'll try to change it. So that's it. Peace.